So this week we have something a little bit different. As you can tell, my 3D printer has morphed into an Amazon box. So we're going to set up the new 3D printer and basically see how it goes. This one here is the exact same model, not make, but model, the Prusa i3. Now this is the second time that I have set up this printer, so things should go pretty smoothly. But this time I'll be able to address things as they come up that I might have noticed from previously building it. So hopefully we can help someone be able to get it set up quick and easy and right the first time. So here we go. There's always a box within a box. So I have it all unboxed now, and I wanted to just note a few differences that I've noticed from unboxing this compared to my previous unit. First of all, all the laser cut pieces are, the brown paper still has to come off of it. But I did notice a lot of the parts were actually already put together. On the previous unit, it didn't have it all put together like this, and I did notice a difference here with this unit. The z-axis, for this part is completely different, so it's all been redesigned with different, before it just used to be it used to just be this part here, and then the rod going through to keep it stable. There was no actual bearings that were inside to help maintain that, which in this one there seems to be that, so that's the bonus. Hopefully we'll get some better results with that. The parts on here, they do have some flaws, but you know what, with 3D printing you're gonna get some flaws here and there. The printed part quality on these, if they have the design files in the micro SD card there, I will probably want to print out some new ones at some point here and replace the plastic parts, because they're not, I think we can print better parts than these and a little bit stronger. So for now that's okay. Everything else is pretty close to the same. The hot end and unit and motor is all pre-assembled where it wasn't on the previous one, so that's good. All the wiring, cables, fans, everything are here. The only difference I noticed really was the hot plate. Instead of having a glass top on this one, it's just the aluminum top. So I'm kind of curious to see how well that works. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get all this lovely nonsense off all the parts here, and then I'll plug in the USB drive and see what kind of setup files we have there to be able to get this guy together here. Other than that, yeah, everything looks a lot similar to the Hisign M505B that I had. You know, there's slight differences. I think a couple different motor sizes, a couple different connectors. This kit did actually, from what I can see here, came with the auto leveling kit. So I do have an extra one of those. So maybe I'll do something with that at some point. Maybe see if I can't do it, use that on another project later on down the road here. But for now, that should do. On this unit here, we just got this 0.25 kilogram roll of filament, whereas on my previous one they actually gave me a full 1 kilogram roll, and I was able to choose between PLA and ABS, and that was through LI Express, where this is just through Amazon and they throw in whatever they want for their kits. So yeah, I'm going to get to getting these parts dealt with so we can get it together and see how she works. Step one will be putting the Y-axis motor onto one of the mounts here. I just got to figure out which one it is. And then we'll go ahead and go through the next little bit here and get the frame all together. So I'll go ahead, I'll record putting that together here. I'll start with the Y-axis, and then it's going to probably go into more of the frame, and I'll explain some things along the way or do a little insert here and there of what's going on. Thank you. base plate for the back all completed here. I'm not too sure if the motor here, if the connector is supposed to be in this position, but if not, we can rotate it up one and put it up top here. I just don't know where the plate for the bed is going to slide over. So to me, I think down here will be more ideal, but I could be wrong. But once it's together, it's just the four screws and then rotate it and we'll have it going. So now we're going to go ahead and get started on the front plate here, and we'll go ahead and get the Y-axis belt holder here, or belt pulley wheel assembly, whatever they want to call it here. Get that guy put in, and then get a couple more of our little sliding rod restrictors put into here as well. And that way we can start getting the cross member done and get this guy together. So let's continue on here.
Thank you.
So now we have it all together, tested it, it's working. The only thing I'm not too sure I like is the auto bed leveling. After 3 years, or give or take, of just using an end stop on my Z-axis, it's a little bit weird getting used to it. And then now adding the G-code, the G29 code into my start script is not a big deal. It's just a little bit different than what I'm used to. So I had some issues with this machine so far, and one being the big one was the wiring was all backwards. So I had to pull the wiring, as you see here, out of the connectors and reassemble them in the proper order. But thankfully I managed to get unplugged and everything rewired to where it needed to be. Now I did use quite a few tools on this that were not either in the package, and it's tools I would recommend if you're putting together your own machine as well. Give you a little bit of an example here. Your keys with it, you're gonna have your leftover parts. I have a level here, a little torpedo level that I use when I am leveling the bed, the Z-axis, just to eyeball it, and then I go ahead and use the tape measure here to finalize my height of my Z-axis and make sure that's all within each other. Now, when putting things together, the magnetic pen here is great for using with the nuts to be able to place them properly into the nut slots there. I added my own zap straps to this unit. The ones that came with it were a little bit thinner and were pretty cheap, and I broke a bunch of them trying to use them in the first place. So I just said, you know what, I'll just use my own. And what I got with my original printer that was not in with this kit was this guy here, and which is great, and I didn't realize how great until I went to go and put this one together. Your little end cutters, your pliers, I had to use some files there to clean out the Z-axis print that came with the unit. By far not the best print quality I've ever seen on a 3D printer, let alone one you purchase on Amazon. So I'll reprint those parts out in a better quality and get those on there at some point as well. Lots of little different screwdrivers. You never know what you're going to need. I have on here a 6mm driver, basically great for when you do have to hold a nut from the behind and be able to screw in as well when you don't have it going into a slot. So that's great to have. Wire cutters, you're going to need that for wiring up your power supply. The power supply wiring is fairly simple and straightforward. Yeah, just go back in the video, you can see where I have all my wires, and the thing is the wiring that you see in the manuals are different colored than what's on there. I did have a multimeter here as well, which is over and back on the shelf there, which I used just to double check my, to make sure I had the right ground on the cable so that way I could plug it into the power supply and it would be all good. Now your micro SD card that you get with your unit, you might not get one of these guys here, a little USB to micro USB adapter. You might just get an SD card, a larger one, and you'll have to get an adapter to be able to transfer those files onto your computer and be able to go through the instruction manuals, things like that. Like I said, when it came to the printer, the wiring was the big issue, but I had another issue, and it was different than the one I had before. I had some binding on the Z-axis here, and I couldn't figure out what was going on. Well, basically what was happening was my bed itself was not properly squared up, causing friction on the the center piece there, and then pushing inward on it and not allowing the rods on the sides here to slide in and out with ease versus having to kind of bend them into the holes. So after resetting my bed here on the bottom there with the nuts, everything squared up, everything's great now. All the printing, there's no binding, so the motors aren't overworking and causing it to jam up. I will get a few different things done to this unit here in the next little bit. A new top for the plate. I'm not sure if I'm going to go with a glass tile or with one of those magnetic sheets here. Maybe test it out, see how it goes. The actual sensor for the Z-axis. I actually bought another one thinking that there wasn't one with this kit. So the kit's link is in the description below, so make sure you check that out. And it does come with the position sensor here. So I've got an extra one here, so maybe I'll try using that with something else and maybe adapt it for a different machine at some point. So other than that, it all looks great, works great. It's exact same printer as I had before. I just have to reset my software for slicing. Once the printer is connected, it ruined my profiles. Well, it didn't ruin it. It actually created a blank default template. It didn't bring over my settings from the previous printer, so I have to reconfigure all that so that way I can use it on here. And what I think I will do at some point here is get a Raspberry Pi to control this printer here, so that way I can just have an LCD and a camera connected to this unit to live stream to me, as well as using repeater host the server software for it. Hopefully that'll go well. I haven't tried it yet, but there's a few things I want to play around with and a bunch of little upgrades. One other issue I had was the end stop on here as well. I'll take a picture of it here. I'll put it up right now. But as you can see, I had to modify it because it wasn't actually stopping. So it wasn't stopping, I couldn't actually configure it. So I ended up just using the wing nut and a screw and the spacer from the board, from the hot plate, to be able to allow it to actually connect on something. Well, I might move it to the top of the mount here, or create a little different bracket for it or something, so that way it actually connects with the machine here. Kind of an annoying little situation, but it does happen. This was, like I said, working. I got a couple more test prints to fine-tune my software end of things, but I'm happy with it so far, minus the little flaws with it so far. But for the price, I wasn't expecting a miracle. It is a replacement for my old printer that, you know, is 3 years old. So anyways, that is it for me today. Stay tuned for next week, and maybe I'll do a project with this guy and let you see how it is going. So thanks for watching, everyone. You have a wonderful day, a wonderful week, and we'll see you next time. Take care, eh?